Epilogue. Some facts about poliomyelitis. It is, or rather was, a very cruel but widespread illness, and remains a deadly part of our world in many regions of the planet. Polio was first recognised as a distinct condition by Jacob Hine in 1840. Its causative agent, poliovirus, was identified in 1908 by Karl Landsteiner. Although major polio epidemics were unknown before the late 19th century, polio was one of the most dreaded childhood diseases of the 20th century. Polio epidemics have crippled thousands of people, mostly young children. The disease has caused paralysis and death for much of human history. Polio had existed for thousands of years quietly as an endemic pathogen until the 1880s, when major epidemics began to occur in Europe. Soon after, widespread epidemics appeared in the United States. By 1910, much of the world experienced a dramatic increase in polio cases, and frequent epidemics became regular events, primarily in cities during the summer months. In order to make a polio diagnosis, the doctor will order certain tests that will look for the virus or antibodies the body has made against the poliovirus. In order to perform these polio tests, a stool sample or a throat swab may be taken. There are a number of diseases and conditions that are similar to polio in signs and symptoms. Bite from a snake, such as a cobra, poisoning, diphtheria, Mycantia gravis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, transvermyelitis, tick paralysis, rabies and botulism. When a person is infected with poliovirus, the virus resides in the intestinal tract and mucus in the nose and throat. Poliovirus transmission most often occurs through contact with stool of this infected person, known as fecal-oral transmission. Less frequently, polio transmission can occur through contact with infected respiratory secretions or saliva, or oral transmission. Common signs and symptoms of polio symptoms include fever, sore throat, and nausea. Symptoms usually appear 7 to 14 days after a person becomes infected with the poliovirus. Up to 95% of people who are infected with poliovirus will have no symptoms. However, people who are infected and do not have symptoms can still spread the poliovirus and cause others to develop polio. When a person becomes infected with poliovirus, the virus begins to multiply within the cells that line the back of the throat, nose, and intestines. Polio symptoms usually appear 7 to 14 days after a person becomes infected with the poliovirus. This period between polio transmission and the start of symptoms is called the polio incubation period. The incubation period for polio can be as short as 4 days or as long as 35 days. Between 1 to 2% of infected people develop aseptic meningitis from poliovirus. For these people, early symptoms can be similar to minor polio symptoms. Then, aseptic meningitis symptoms can develop, including stiffness of the back or legs and increased or abnormal sensations. These symptoms can improve rapidly, usually within a couple of days, 2 to 10 days, with complete recovery. With paralytic poliomyelitis, less than 1% of cases will result in paralysis. In these severe cases, symptoms begin with fever, muscle aches, loss of reflexes, and other minor illness symptoms. These early symptoms improve after several days. However, 5 to 10 days later, the fever returns and paralysis begins. Paralysis progresses for 2 to 3 days. Once the temperature returns to normal, there is usually no further paralysis. Along with paralysis, other polio symptoms with paralytic poliomyelitis can include painful muscle cramps and muscle twitching. The risk of paralysis from polio increases with age. In children under the age of 5, paralysis of one leg is common. In adults, paralysis of both arms and legs is common. Muscles controlling urination and breathing might also be affected. Many people with paralytic poliomyelitis recover completely and muscle function returns to some degree. However, paralysis after 6 months is usually permanent. People who develop serious symptoms, including paralysis, may experience complications. Polio complications in severe cases may include inflammation of the heart muscle, myocarditis, high blood pressure, hypertension, fluid in the lungs, pulmonary edema, pneumonia, urinary tract infection, UTIs. Approximately 2 to 5% of children and 15 to 30% of adults with paralytic polio die from the poliovirus infection. Fortunately, widespread and effective vaccination to protect the young was developed and distributed globally after the Second World War, and this dreadful disease was all but eliminated in the industrialised world. In 1988, when the Global Polio Eradication Initiative began, polio paralysed more than 1,000 children worldwide every day. Since then, over 2.5 billion children have been immunised thanks to the cooperation of more than 200 countries and 20 million volunteers, backed by an international investment exceeding $8 billion. Post-polio syndrome, or PPS, is a neurological condition which can occur in up to 80% of those who have had polio. It is thought that around 120,000 people in the UK alone are living with the effects of polio or PPS today. After an interval of several years of stability, individuals can develop increasing weakness, fatigue and pain in previously affected or unaffected muscles, a general reduction in stamina, breathing, sleeping and or swallowing problems, and cold intolerance. PPS usually begins very slowly, although it can appear suddenly and often following triggers such as falls, surgery or immobility. There is no specific cure for PPS, but properly managed it may stabilise or only progress slowly and lessen the cost. Much can be done to retain independence, including appropriate treatment for symptoms, self-management strategies such as pacing and energy management, appropriate use of adaptive equipment, looking after your general health, and social and emotional support. I am proud to be an ambassador for the British Polio Fellowship, which is a charity dedicated to helping, supporting and empowering those in the UK living with the effects of polio and post-polio syndrome. It provides information, advocacy, welfare and support to enable its members to live full, independent and integrated lives, and works to develop worldwide alliances with other polio and post-polio groups for the mutual benefit of its members. Some of these other charitable groups include the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, who work tirelessly to eliminate this disease, alongside Rotary International.